Students, Sairam, this is Megha Miss here, and today we will continue with our lesson number 9, carbon compounds. This is our session 3, students. Okay, now in the last session we were discussing about carbon, a versatile element was the last topic which we were discussing. So we'll continue with that topic. Okay, students, now we'll see some characteristics of carbon. So the first one, students, carbon has a unique ability to form strong covalent bonds with other carbon atoms. This results in the formation of big molecules. Okay, so carbon, it has got a unique ability that it can form a strong covalent bonds with the other carbon atoms. Okay, and this results in the formation of the big molecules. Okay, this property of carbon is called catenation power. We called it as the catenation power. Okay, the carbon compounds contain open chains or closed chains of carbon atoms. Okay, so it can be an open chain it can form, or a closed chain of carbon it can form. An open chain can be a straight chain or a branch chain. Okay, a closed chain is a ring structure, like a ring it can form. Okay, the covalent bond between two carbon atoms is strong and therefore stable. Okay, students, due to the strong and stable covalent bonds, carbon is bestowed with catenation power. Okay, so it carbon is the has got this unique ability, and this unique ability is what, student, that it can form the covalent bonds with other carbon atoms and form the big molecules. They can be straight chain, they can be branched, or they can be in a ring structure. Okay, students, I hope the first characteristic of carbon is clear to you. Okay, we'll move to the next one. Here I am showing you the structure of glucose. Now this is a complex structure, but for your understanding of straight chain form. Now here you can see the structural formula of a straight chain form. So this is the straight chain. Okay, you can see this, all carbons, they are attached in a straight chain. Okay, just a moment, again I'll show you. See here, all this carbon, they are attached in a straight chain. Okay, students, so this is the structural formula of a straight chain form of a glucose. This is the structure how glucose we draw. Okay, similarly, you can see the branching is also done. Can you see this OH is attached? Okay, so a branching is done, right? This H is attached, the branches, we can say them, they are the branched. Okay, then structural formula of a ring form, as we have seen, they can also form a ring. You can see this carbon, 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 and one oxygen, another molecule. Yes, it is also attached in that ring. So this can also happen. Okay, and this is a three-dimensional structure. We'll not study that now. Okay, students, you don't have it now. So we'll just see for your better understanding straight chain form, how you can see it is, and ring structures they can form. Okay, we'll proceed, students. Now beep one, the second one, two carbon atoms can be bonded together by one, two, or three covalent bonds. Okay, how many bonds they can form, students? They can form one, two, or three covalent bonds. These are called single bond, double bond, and triple bond respectively. Due to the ability of carbon atoms to form multiple bonds as well as single bonds, the number of carbon compounds increases. Okay, so as it has got the capability of forming a double bond, triple bond, number of whatever the carbon compounds are there, they are going on increasing. For example, there are three compounds, namely ethane. Okay, these are the, after methane, these are the basics: ethane, CH3-CH3, ethene, CH2 double bond CH2 we write, and ethyne, CH triple bond CH we write. Okay, which contain two carbon atoms. Yes, ethane, it has ethane formula means it contains the carbon atoms are two. So ethane you will write CH3-CH3, one single bond. If I may want to make a double bond, then it will become CH2 double bond CH2. So the name will change to ethene. And if I want to make a triple bond between those carbon atoms, then it will become CH triple bond CH, and it will be known as ethyne. Okay, students, so you have ethene, okay, and ethyne, and the main one is the ethane. Okay, we'll proceed, students. Being tetravalent, one carbon atom can form bonds with four other atoms. Yes, four it should, as you know, its valence is four. Okay, carbon or any other it can be. This results in the formation of many compounds. These compounds possess different properties as per the atoms to which carbon is bonded. For example, 5 different compounds are formed using one carbon atom and two monovalent elements, hydrogen and chlorine. Okay, if I use, so you have CH4, CH3Cl, CH2Cl2, CHCl3, CCl4. So see how many compounds are formed. Okay, similarly, carbon atoms form covalent bonds with atoms of the elements alike oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogen, okay, and P to form different types of carbon compounds in large numbers. Okay, students, so many of these, non-metals also carbon can attach and it can form a new compound. Okay, so we'll just see here, you can see how it is bonded to 4Cl. So it forms CCl4. Okay, how the bonding, 4 bonds, covalent bonds are formed with the 4 chlorine atoms. Okay, and here you can see the next molecular diagram for the CH3Cl. Okay, structural diagram, we'll see the molecular formula is CH3Cl. Okay, so like this it will be drawn. Okay, students, I hope both the diagrams are clear to you. Okay, the structure diagrams. Okay, now we'll proceed further, students. D1, carbon has one more characteristic which is responsible for large number of carbon compounds. It is isomerism. So this is one, shortly we will learn about it, students, but you will remember the fourth characteristic is carbon has one more characteristic that it is responsible for forming large number of carbon compounds is its isomerism. So we'll study isomerism in the next coming hour presentations. Okay, students, so I hope the four characteristics of the carbon you have understood. First one, you will be remembering catenation power. Okay, in short you can remember. Second, you know they will be forming type of compounds, many type of compounds they can form. Okay, and we have seen the examples also. Okay, third, again you are going to remember, yes, they can form the different with the carbon, as it is a tetravalent, you know this. So with hydrogen and chlorine, okay, two monovalent, we have seen the atoms we are using and we are forming many compounds of the carbon. And the fourth you will remember, isomerism. Okay, students, I hope this part is clear. Okay, we'll proceed, students. So now we are going to start with the hydrocarbons, saturated and unsaturated. Okay, you must have heard this word before also. Now what is this exactly? We will see that carbon compounds contain many elements. The element hydrogen is present to a smaller or large extent in the majority of carbon compounds. Okay, the compounds which contain carbon and hydrogen as only the two elements are called the hydrocarbons. Okay, students, you will remember it. The compounds which contain carbon and hydrogen as the only two elements are called as hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are the simplest and the fundamental organic compounds. Okay, students, the smallest hydrocarbon is methane. You have studied this in the last year also, students. Formed by the combination of one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms. So what is the structure, uses and all you have studied last year, right? So please go through again, structure also you can see in that how we are drawing it. Yes, so you will remember, students, definition for hydrocarbons, that the compounds which are contain carbon and hydrogen as the only two elements, we call them as hydrocarbons. The smallest hydrocarbon, students, is methane, CH4. And how it is formed? By the combination of one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms. Okay, is it clear? Okay, we'll proceed. Ethane is one more hydrocarbon. Now only we saw ethane, ethene and ethyne. So see, this is ethane is one of the hydrocarbon. Okay, students, its molecular formula is C2H6. You will remember this. The first step in writing the line structure, or we say the structural formula of a hydrocarbon, is to join the carbon atoms in the molecule with single bonds. First we have to join the carbon atoms, okay, and then we have to put on the hydrogens. And then in the second step, use the hydrogen atoms in the molecular formula so as to fulfill the remaining valencies of the tetravalent carbon atoms. Okay, students, first we will link the carbon atoms together, and then wherever how many hydrogen atoms are needed to complete, you know, the four bonds of one carbon, we will go on adding the hydrogen. Okay, I hope it is clear to you till here. Yes, should I repeat this again? Ethane is one more hydrocarbon. Its molecular formula is C2H6. You will remember this. The first step in writing the line structure, that is the structural formula, or you can say line structure, both are correct, of a hydrocarbon is to join the carbon atoms in the molecule with single bonds. Okay? And then in the second step, what you will do? You will use the hydrogen atoms in the molecular formula so as to fulfill the remaining valencies of the tetravalent carbon atoms. Okay, student? I hope this part is clear to you. Okay, we'll proceed. Ethane, molecular formula C2H6. First step is to join the two carbon atoms with single bonds C-C. Okay, so what you will do? You can see the line structure or the structure formula of ethane is given. First, this is my first carbon, this is my second, and I have joined them by this single bond. Okay, now use the 6 hydrogen atoms in the molecular formula for fulfilling the tetravalency of both the carbon atoms. Okay, means both the carbon, you should have the 4 bonds should be formed. Okay, so see, if I take the first carbon, if this is my first carbon, see, this is my bond 1, 2, 3, and with this carbon is the 4th one. Yes. So, the tetravalency is satisfied of the first carbon. Okay, students. Now, if I see the second carbon, okay, just a moment, we'll see the second carbon. See, this is my second carbon, one bond with this. This is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth bond, right? So, this carbon atom also, the tetravalency is complete. Okay, so we will say that this is the structural formula of ethane. Okay, students, now electron dot structure is also given. You have studied this. Okay, so you can see as it is formed by the sharing of electrons, right? So see here, this blue color are the electrons of carbon, and this hydrogen is also sharing its 1-1 electron. And see, these two carbon atoms are also sharing this between, you can see the 2 electrons, red color. Okay, same way how you will draw. See the structure. Here is the structure how you will draw for the ethane. Okay, you will practice all these structures in your notebook. Okay, students, in your science notebook, draw the structures. Okay, now propane. Now next, you completed with methane, 1 carbon atom. Ethane, 2 carbon atoms were there. Now the third one is the propane. We write it as C3H8, and you can see how the 3 carbons, they are attached. See, this is 1, this is 2, and this is my 3. So first I will attach the 3 carbon atoms. See, they are attached by these bonds. Okay, now this carbon atom, see, 1, 2, 3, and this is the 4th bond. This is the 4th bond with the carbon. Okay, satisfied the tetravalency. This carbon, you will see only 2 hydrogens are needed, right? Because this is the 1 bond with this carbon atom, and this is the another bond with the next carbon atom. Okay, students, I hope it is clear. So only 2 you need to complete the tetravalency. So we have added only 2 hydrogens. Okay, this carbon, you will see one bond it is forming with this carbon atom. This is the second, third, and fourth bond. Okay, so I hope this part is also clear to you. So this is the structure for propane. Electron dot structure you will draw, students. Okay, practice drawing all these diagrams, structural formula diagrams, in your notebook. Okay, I hope it is clear to you till here. Okay, we'll proceed, students. From the structural formula of ethane and propane, it is seen that the valencies of all the elements, the valency of all the elements, or we can say the valencies of all the atoms, okay, are satisfied by the single bonds. We have seen all we have drawn that are the single bonds. Okay, such compounds are called saturated compounds. So such compounds you will call it as a saturated compound. Okay students, ethane and propane are saturated hydrocarbons. Why? Because they are satisfied by the single bonds. So when you have single bonds, we will say that they are the saturated hydrocarbon students. Okay, saturated hydrocarbons are also called as alkanes. Important to remember this line. Okay, saturated hydrocarbons, we also call them as alkanes. And next thing you will remember that we are showing them, they have the presence of the single bonds. Okay students, I hope it is clear till here. Okay, so we have come to the end of today's presentation. So today we studied about students characteristic of carbon atom. We saw the four characteristic of carbon atom. Properly you go through them. Catenation power, isomerism, we'll be studying in detail, but we have seen that different bigger molecules are formed from the carbon as it is linking, right? Yes, as it is forming a straight chain, branch chain or a ring chain compounds. Okay, and then we saw about the saturated hydrocarbons, which we also call them as alkanes. Yes, so please go through the presentation properly, study well. Okay, all the structures, as I told you, you draw in the notebook and practice. Okay, in your science notebook, draw all the structures of ethane, methane, methane and all you will get in last year textbook. So please practice them, so it will be good for you. Okay students, so I'll stop it here for today. Okay, take care. Thank you. Sairam.